going to share something with you today. It is my mother's secret pie crust recipe. It's okay, she told me I could do this. But she does have a secret ingredient she uses in her pie crusts. I'll start by showing you how she begins her pie crust, which is just like everyone else's. I have 2½ cups of all-purpose flour here in the bowl. Then she adds, again, just like everybody else, a little salt. This is 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Here comes the secret ingredient. 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Some people might say, hey, that's cheating. But really, I asked my mother about why she thought about even using this, and she said, you know, every once in a while, my pie crust wouldn't turn out quite right. And that was one day that I decided, let's try some baking powder in here and see if that's going to work. Well, it did, and she's been doing it ever since. So, cheating or not, this is her secret recipe for making pie crust. Those are the basic ingredients. Then, 1 cup of vegetable shortening. Again, that's very much like everyone else's. We'll get that in there and we will work that into the flour. And you'll see what we get. I use a pastry blender and we work that in until we end up with small pea-sized homogeneous lumps throughout the dough. Getting there already. As you can see, evenly distributed. I'll do just a little bit more. And then, also like everybody else, we add a little ice water. That should be just fine. Measurements don't really make much difference with this because of the differences between flours. It might be the humidity where you live, the moisture content that's already in your flour, the different things like that. I start with several tablespoons. It's probably about 5 or 6, but let's get that worked in and see what we have so far. You're going to do that until you get a dough that just barely pulls together. Quite dry here. Go slowly too because it's really easy to get too much moisture into your dough. But at some point here you're going to have to use your hands to see how this pulls together. I think I've got what I want. So what I'm going to do is put a little extra flour out here on this surface so that I'll be able to work and pull the dough together so that I have a nice homogeneous lump that kind of holds together. Sometimes I have to take it in a couple of parts, but I can see when they're sticking together, I'll pull them together and get exactly what we're going to need. Just a little bit more moisture in that little piece. Getting this. Now I'm going to lightly squeeze this together, wrap it in Saran wrap, and put it into the refrigerator for 20 minutes. Then when it's chilled again, I'll bring it back out and we'll work this. And it's ready to go. I've got a little flour here on the surface, and we'll work this out. Pretty simple and easy. I've got the oven already heating to 400 degrees. I don't think it's quite up to temperature yet, but we'll see. And I'm going to today just bake a simple bare pie shell for, oh, say making a lemon pie, putting something in that where you need a pre-baked pie shell. But this overall recipe can be used for unbaked pie crust too, where you put the filling in and then bake your pie. And as a matter of fact, I want to cut this in half and save half of this, because this is a double recipe. So let's just save that. I'll roll that out just a little bit later for a second piece. Get this closer to a round and go forward with this. Otherwise, that would have been one large piece of pie crust. All right, we're ready to keep going here. This doesn't take long. There goes that one spot. And yeah, in fact, I'm going to leave that and show you what my mother does. We've got it essentially ready. Put this over here. Fold the crust over. And bring the pie tin and put the crust in here. All right, and you see we have a little bit of a crack. We just press that together as we gentle it into the pie plate. This is a 9-inch pie plate. This would easily fit a 10 inch. Let's grab a knife here. Step over here and get a bit of a knife for this. Now, keeping this simple, I'm just going to go around the edges. I have a purpose for some of these in a few minutes too, so don't go away. I have something else to show you. I like to run a fork around the edge of the pie crust. Just to make it look a little bit better. And then prick a few times in the shell. You'll often see some cooks put foil in here and spread beans to keep it more even. And I do that once in a while. I'm not doing that today. Today is all about the crust and not necessarily about some of the finer points, but let's get that into the oven. That may take about 10 minutes, and I'll be back when that's finished. Well, this is perfect. See how beautiful that is? Lightly golden. This is ready for virtually any filling. I'm going to set this aside and let it cool. And rather than wreck this in order to show you how flaky it is, I'm going to make, with some of this leftover dough that we just made, pie crust cookies. Did your mother ever make those? I'll show you how my mother makes hers. I have a few started left over from when we made that crust, and this is really the way my mother made them. She didn't cut them up in any uniform manner at all. These were just the scraps and the cuttings from around the pie, and they then were sprinkled with sugar and cinnamon. I'll do that in just a moment. I had some of that pie crust left over as before, and you know, you could take a cookie cutter in any kind of a shape and do this and make interesting and uniform shapes. You could cut them into diamonds and squares like these. I never do that. Really, we just, since this is rolled out and not scraps from a pie crust, we just make a few cuts so that we can get it onto the tray. Lay them out randomly. Different sizes. You should see the little ones fight over who gets the bigger one. A lesson in sharing. Sugar right into the tray. It'll caramelize on the cookie sheet. That's not a problem. No measurements. Cinnamon's coming out here slightly. Same thing. No measurements. You could mix the sugar and the cinnamon together, but my mother never did that either. And this on the second shelf. We'll watch this and I will show you as soon as they're finished how flaky they are. Careful. Okay. Now, let's take a look. Let's give you a good look. See how these look? All different sizes. Golden to getting brown. And here, let's take one out here just like this. This is still warm, but look at how crumbly and flaky that is. Yeah, I'm wrecking one just to show you how wonderfully flaky they are. These are perfect. So try this pie crust recipe.